hello to all you cookie lovers, and maybe the one person who isn't. I'm your host, Ruby J, and today we'll be dipping into what they got right about Oreo cookies. Yep, definitely milk's favorite cookie.
Grab a glass of milk, it's a cookie cream delight. We talk an Oreo, this is what they got right.
For a cookie that's been around for over 100 years and has sold 450 billion cookies, you'd expect Oreo's origin story to be pretty epic. But did you know that Oreos weren't expected to be a runaway hit? It started as a copycat of another cookie, Hydrox. Oreo had a sweeter vanilla cream and its cookie absorbed milk better, so it quickly overtook Hydrox in popularity. But some cookie insiders speculate that Oreo beat Hydrox simply because Hydrox sounds more like a laundry detergent than a delicious treat. Not only did Oreo start off as a cookie clone, but it was one of three cookies set to be released on the same day. Talk about middle cookie syndrome! But Oreo quickly outshined the Veronese and Mother Goose biscuits, quickly proving to be more than an ugly duckling. Available in over 100 countries, almost everyone has heard the word Oreo. The irony of that is that not even the people at Oreo know the origin of its name. To this day, it remains a mystery not even Scooby-Doo can solve. But maybe Daphne can. The most popular theory is that Oreo stems from the plant family called Oreodaphne that contains the wreath on Oreo's first design. Well, there you have it, folks. The world's best-selling cookie was most likely named after plants. What next? We find out Frappuccinos are named after pants? Birthday cake, red velvet, watermelon, cinnamon bun. Today, Oreo launches multiple flavors a year. That's fascinating because its first new flavor failed so badly in the 1920s that Oreo almost never made a new one again. That's right, thanks to the unpopularity of lemon cream, for 50 years, Oreo didn't launch a new flavor. Well, you know what they say. When life gives you lemons, don't make an Oreo. Luckily, the Double Stuff Oreo saved the day in 1974 and ushered in new flavors. Today, Oreos are popular with vegans and meat eaters alike, but it wasn't always that way. Originally, Oreos were made with animal lard, but in the 1990s, they replaced the animal lard with unicorn tears, and the rest is history. Just kidding. They replaced lard with non-hydrogenated vegetable oil, but that isn't as fun as unicorn tears. Today, Oreo is the most popular cookie in the world, with some flavors only available in certain countries. Outside of America, China is the biggest consumer of Oreos in the world, but it didn't start out like that. They originally disliked them so much that Oreo started packing its bags to head home. But then, for the first time ever, Oreo changed its recipe. They made the chocolate chocolatier and the vanilla less sweet. And they did something even crazier that they never would have done at home. They changed the shape. Oreo wafers, Oreo straws, and Oreo cakes. China gobbled them up and revolutionized what is now the world's favorite cookie. At this rate, they'll be on Mars by the 4th of July. The Oreo cookie went from a humble beginning to being the best-selling cookie of the 21st century, all because of its catchy name, delicious flavors, and a little bit of milk. Thanks for watching What They Got Right. And don't forget to subscribe to DreamWorks TV for new videos every single day. Also, leave a comment below letting us know which Oreo flavor you wish existed. Until next time, milk mustache time.